ॐ शन्नो मित्रस्यं वरुणः शन्नो भवत्वर्यमा शन्न इन्द्र बृहस्पतिः शन्नो विष्णुरुक्रमः नमो ब्रह्मणे नमस्ते वायो त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्मासि त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्म वदिष्यामि ऋतं वदिष्यामि सत्यं वदिष्यामि तन्मामवतु तद्वक्तारमवतु अवतु माम् अवतु वक्तारम् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते नस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्याम् मामा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरते य उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ यो ब्रह्माणं विदधाति पूर्वं यो वै वेदांश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तं ह देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्मविद्यासम्प्रदायकर्तृभ्यो भ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहितः प्रज्ञानघनः प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ॐ नारायणं पद्मभवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तन्तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यान् अस्मद्गुरून् सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ इत्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासीत ओमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम् तदनन्यत्वम् आरम्भणशब्दादिभ्यः न च इयम् अवगतिः न उत्पद्यते इति शक्यं वक्तुम् यू कैनॉट से दैट दिस नॉलेज ऑफ द नॉन ड्युअलिटी ऑफ आत्मा डज नॉट टेक प्लेस तद्धास्य विजज्ञौ इत्यादि श्रुतिभ्यः फ्रॉम द टीचिंग ऑफ द सेज उद्दालक द फादर दैट श्वेतकेतु डिड कम टू गेन दिस नॉलेज And this and similar statements show that knowledge does take place. Avagati sadhananam cha sharvanadinam vedanuvachanadinam cha vidhanat. Also, the Shastra prescribes the antaranga sadhanas, bahiranga sadhanam, the inner, the proximate and the remote means, sharvanadinam, Sarvanam mananam di antaranga sadhanam and Vedanuvachanam bahiranga sadhanam, these are prescribed. So this suppose knowledge takes place, so what? Nacha iyam avagatihi anarthika bhrantirvayati shakyam vaktum. You cannot say that this knowledge does not generate the benefit or that Aham Brahmasmi is a Brahma, is a delusion and not a reality. You cannot say that. Avidya Nivritti Phaladarshanat. This knowledge dispels the ignorance. This is what we find. And by dispelling ignorance, it also dispels the samsara, the sorrow, which is the product of ignorance. Bhadakantar abhavacha, you cannot say that this is Brahma. Aham Brahmasmi is not brainwashing. It's not a delusion created in your mind. By constantly being told, you are Brahman Swamiji, are we not being brainwashed? No. Because once that knowledge takes place that I am Brahman, Bhadakantar abhavat, there is no other knowledge that displaces it, that negates that. It is the antyam, the ultimate knowledge, not subject to improvement or change or negation. What is bhranti? For example, seeing a snake where there is rope, that is called bhranti, which is bhadayogya, which can be negated by the knowledge of the rope. Here, there is nothing, no other knowledge that can negate this. Prakcha atmekatva avagatehe avyahatah sarvah satyanurda vyavaharah laukiko vaidikasyeti avochama. And all these vyavahara, the transaction, the interaction in duality is not a problem. Prakcha atmaikatva avagatehe. Before the knowledge of the non-duality of the self, the duality is taken to be real, and that perception and other means of knowledge have a scope with reference to duality which is unreal. But even unreal also, as long as it is not known to be unreal, is real in the eyes of the perceiver. Similarly also, this duality, as long as one does not know that it is mithya, so long it is satyam, true, as the dream is. So just as in the dream also, all the subject, object, transaction takes place. Even though the reality of the dream is that the object is not apart from subject, atmanamevadvayam, there is only one non-dual atma, the self in dream. But the duality is superimposed by ignorance, and until one wakes up to the reality of oneself, that duality is taken to be real. And so also, to explain the vyavahara, you do not have to imagine, you do not have to give reality to duality. The Brahma or delusion also can accomplish the same purpose, as long as a Brahma is not known as Brahma. So avyahatah, uncontradicted, sarvah satyanuda vyavaharah laukiko vedikascha, all satya and anuta. See, in the realm of mithya also, there is something called satyam, like the water which we drink. Something is called mithya, like the mirage water. All this vyavahara is intact. As long as we do not realize that both kinds of waters are mithya, until then, this vyavahara remains intact. Tasmad antyena pramanena pratipadite atmaikatve samastasya prachinasya bheda vyavaharasya bhaditatvat. Therefore, antyena pramanena, Upanishad is the ultimate pramanam, the final verdict of the Supreme Court, nothing to challenge. And so, antyena pramanena pratipadite atmaikatve, the non-duality of self, which is delineated by or taught by Vedanta, which is the ultimate pramanam. Samastasya, once you wake up from the dream, then dream no more remains real, or the dream vyavahara is no reality anymore. Similarly, when you wake up from this dream of duality, that vyavahara and duality does not remain real anymore. Even if vyavahara takes place on the part of the wise person, there is no reality given to that. So, veda vyavahara se bhadi tattva, at that time, what remains is non-duality. The duality being completely negated or sublated. Therefore, na anekatmaka brahma kalpana avakasha asti. Therefore, to explain the vyavahara and duality, there is no reason for you to imagine that Brahman is a composite entity consisting of the Bheda and Abheda, duality and non-duality. He says, but your Upanishad itself says that Brahman is Parinami or subject to transformation. Nanu mrudadi drishtanta pranayanat parinamivat brahma shastrasya abhimatamiti gamyate. Shastra does not directly say that Brahman is changeful. But from the illustration given by the Shastra, illustration of the clay, etc., given by the Shastra, the clay definitely is changeful. Parinamino hi mrudadeo loke adhigamaha adhigataha. Everybody knows that the clay and the gold and the iron, all the examples which are given, all of them are changeful. So when Shruti gives the example of clay, etc., which are changeful, it seems to suggest that Brahman which is illustrated by a clay, etc., also must be changeful. Iti gamyate, this arthapatti. Had Brahman not been changeful, the example of clay, etc., would not have been, some other example would have been given. The fact that example of clay, gold, which are changeful substances, are given, therefore, we can conclude that Brahman also is changeful. Na iti uchyate, no, that is not right. Because this conclusion, you can derive this conclusion from the illustration of clay, etc. But that conclusion will contradict what is clearly stated elsewhere. See, changefulness is not clearly stated, that is something that is presumed, derived. Whereas that Brahman is changeless is very clearly stated. Sava esha mahanaja atma ajaro maro mruto bhayo brahma. That atma is birthless. When birth is not there, no other modification can be there. Birthless means what? Ever existing. Birthless means not subject to birth, which means what? Ever existing. Is not like Shasha Shrunga or the horn of a hare, which also doesn't have birth. No. This is ever existent. Therefore, it has no birth. So, ajaha atma. Ajaraha, free from old age or decrepitude. Amaraha, amrutaha, abhayaha, atma is Brahma. Very clear, iti atmanaha. Ityadyabhya, sarvavikriya, saesha, neti neti atma. Not this, not this. All the visheshas or the distinctions are negated in the atma. Asthulam, ananu. It is not gross, not minute, and similarly, all visheshas or attributes are all denied or negated in Atma, revealing that Atma is nirvishesha, devoid of all vishesha. Therefore, it is niravayava, it is partless, and therefore kutastha, changeless. Ityadyabhya, sarvavikriya pratishedha shrutibhya, Brahmana kutasthatva avagamat. So from this Shrutis, it is very clear that Brahman is kutastham, changeless. And therefore, to imagine that Brahman is changeful would very much contradict this clear statement. They are all spashta vakyas. That Brahman is changeful is only presumed. Whereas these vakyas clearly state that Brahman is changeless. Why not Brahman is both changeless and changeful? Says one entity cannot be simultaneously possessed of the contradictory attributes. So Brahman cannot be simultaneously changeless and changeful because that is contradictory. Nahi ekasya brahmanah parinama dharmatvam tadrahitatvam cha shakyam pratipattum. Ekasya brahmanah, brahman which is one, non-dual, one. To imagine that one brahman alone is simultaneously changing and changeful is self-contradictory, so it cannot be. So Purupakshi says, why not? It is changeless now and changing later on. In Pralaya Avastha, Brahman is changeless. In Srishti Avastha, it is changeful. Why not? Sthiti gati vat syadidi chet. Like Devadatta is standing right now, he is moving later on. Na kutasthasyeti visheshanat. Says, no. That also is not possible because then Brahman will no more be kutastham. Because if Brahman undergoes change, at any time, if Brahman undergoes change at any time, then it means that even when it appeared changeless, there was a potential of change. In the deep sleep state, everything seems to be unchanging. But as soon as you wake up, all change happens. That means that in the deep sleep state also, the change was potentially there. Looks like in deep sleep state, there is no desire at all. But as soon as you wake up, you find yourself desiring. That means that the potential of desire was very much there in deep sleep state. Similarly, if Brahman is changeful during the sthiti or the sustenance, then even at the time of dissolution, pralaya, it appears to be unchanging, it has potential of change, so it is changing only, it is not kutastha. Kutastha means that which does not change, which means that which does not have potential of changing also. Kutastha seti visheshanat, Brahman is kutastham, changeless, and therefore it cannot have change at any time. Nahi kutasthasya brahmana sthiti gativat aneka dharma ashayatvam sambhavate. Brahman, that is kutastham sthiti gativat, now it is changeless and then it is changing aneka atmakatvam. So this Devadatta, who is motionless now and moving later on, is anekātmaka. Devadatta is a composite entity consisting of many limbs. So Devadatta is a stander also, is a walker also, is a sleeper also, is an eater also. You follow? So all this multifoldness is there in Devadatta, therefore Devadatta is always changing. Even when he appears to be standing, there is a potential of running there. So Brahman cannot be aneka dharma ashrayam. So Brahman being changeless cannot be ashraya or the locus of many dharmas. It is nirdharmakam, devoid of all attributes. So Nyayadevana said, parinaminam hi banapashanadinam kramena sthitigati yukte. Like an arrow, his parinam is changeful. Therefore, right now it is motionless when it is on the bow, and then it is moving when it is released from the bow. Similarly, stone also, changefulness is the nature of stone. Therefore, it can be non-moving now when it is somebody's hands, and starts moving when it is thrown. Nandu parinama ayogyasya. How is Brahman? Kutastha means what? Parinama ayogyam. Which does not have potential of change, you know. By nature, Brahman does not have anything in it which will make it changing. In this body, there are many limbs, and therefore the motion can be there, change can be there. So the potential of change is there. But Brahman being changeless, it is devoid of potential of change also. Therefore, kramena parinama tadrahitye brahmana nasyatam. Therefore, in Brahman, changefulness and changelessness cannot be there. These contradictory attributes cannot be in Brahman. Brahman cannot be locus of these contradictory attributes. So then says Nyayendra, all right, these two things cannot be there simultaneously in Brahman. changefulness and change. It's okay. Says Brahmani Virudha Dharma Asambhave Kutasthattvam Hitva Parinamitvam Vaishyatam Iti. When you say that Brahman cannot be the locus of the contradictory attributes like changefulness and changelessness, okay. So discard the changelessness and say that Brahman is changing. So you are saying that Brahman cannot be changing because it is opposed to changelessness. Why not we say that Brahman is changing? Discard the changelessness which is opposed to changing and say that Brahman is changing. Why not? If two things cannot remain in Brahman simultaneously or even in sequence, then one of them can be there. So why do you insist that Brahman is changeless? Why not Brahman can be changeful? So Bhashyakara says on the page 381, first line, कूटस्थम च नित्यं ब्रह्मन् सर्वक्रिया प्रतिषेधात् इत्यवोचाम. But Shruti clearly says, what is the nature of Brahma? कूटस्थम च नित्यं ब्रह्मन् Brahman is, so it is said, सवा एष महान अज आत्मा अजह अजरह अमरह एटसेट्रा. सो श्रुति क्लियरली सेज ब्रह्मन इज कूटस्थम. वी आर नॉट सेइंग इट, श्रुति सेज, एंड दैट वी ऑलरेडी सेड दैट यू कांट से दैट व्हाई नॉट ब्रह्मन इज चेंजफुल. कूटस्थम च नित्यम ब्रह्म, ब्रह्मन इज कूटस्थम, चेंजलेस, नित्यम, eternal, sarva vikriya pratishedat, because all vikriyas, all the change has been negated in Brahman, iti avochama, this is what we already said. So you can't discard changelessness and adopt changefulness because that is not accepted by Shruti, that is not in conformity with the Shruti. Says Jnayanirana, anavayava, anavachinna, kutastha brahmanaha, swarupat, aprachyutasvahavasya, saraprakara, tadvipaita karyakara, parinama shruti anupatya. Anavayava, Brahman is partless. Anavachinna, it is limitless. Kutastha, it is changeless. Brahmana, the limitless. Swarupat aprachyuta svabhavasya. See, Brahman's nature is such that it cannot ever fall from its nature. That which is partless, that which is limitless, that which is changeless, there is no way that it can undergo change. अविनाशु तद्विद्धि येन सर्वमिदं ततं विनाशमव्ययस्यास्य न कश्चित् कर्तुमर्हति. आत्मा इज अविनाशी, इज नॉन डिस्ट्रक्टिबल, बिकॉज द पोटेंशियल ऑफ डिस्ट्रक्शन इज नॉट देयर. सो ब्रह्मन एवर रिमेन्स एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन इट्स ग्लोरी, इन इट्स ओन नेचर, बिकॉज there is nothing can make Brahman fall or get, you know, distracted from its nature. A fruit has a potential of being rotted. Therefore, even when it is fresh, it is possible that if it is left for a while, it may get rotted. But a stone will not get rotted because the potential of being rotted is not there. So Brahman can never be diverted from its nature, can never be fallen from its nature, because that potential of falling is not there. स्वरूपाद अप्रच्युत स्वभावस्य सर्व प्रकार तद विपरीत कार्य का परिणाम शुद्ध अनुपत्या. देयरफॉर ब्रह्मन कैन नॉट चेंज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कार्य और द जगत अनुपत्ति. इवन इफ श्रुति सीम्स टू से दैट ब्रह्मन बिकेम जगत, वी हैव टू इंटरप्रेट द श्रुति अप्रोप्रिएटली बिकॉज ब्रह्मन इज नो पोटेंशियल ऑफ चेंज. देन वी हैव टू से ब्रह्मन एज दो चेंजेस इन टू जगत. दैट्स व्हाट द कारिककार सेड इन द अद्वैत प्रकरणम. इसको अजातवाद है. दैट जाति बर्थ इज नॉट पॉसिबल. When you look at the creation, then Vaitatya Prakaranam, then the creation is Mithya, is very clear. When you look at Brahman, then Mithya, then there is no change possible in Brahman at all. Therefore, Brahman cannot be born. Ajatam means it is unborn. Therefore, no real birth or no real creation has taken place because Brahman does not have the potential of any real creation. So, sarva prakara tad viparita karyakara. Jagat consists of all these contradictory things. Parinama shruti anupatya. Brahman cannot get transformed into a jagat like this. Karya, then what is the nature of this jagat? How is it created? Karya prapanchasya स्वरूपात अप्रच्युत शुक्त्यादे रजतादि परिणामवत. दैट प्रश्न ऑलरेडी सेड, इट इज नॉट परिणाम, इट इज विवर्त. जस्ट एज द शुक्तिका ऑफ द शेल गेट्स ट्रांसफॉर्म एज दो इन टू सिल्वर, सो ऑल्सो ब्रह्मन एज दो गेट ट्रांसफॉर्म इन टू द क्रिएशन. मीनिंग जस्ट एज द शेल अपियर्स टू बी सिल्वर, सो ऑल्सो Brahman appears to be Jagat. Therefore, Mithya Vivartatvam Siddhyati. So, Jagat is Mithya, it is superimposed upon Brahman. That's what gets established because Brahman is changeless. Brahman being changeless, Jagat has to be Mithya. There cannot be real Jagat. If Jagat was real, then it means that Brahman has undergone a real change to become Jagat. But Brahman cannot undergo change because it does not have what it takes to change, you know. The clay has something that it can change because clay is a composite entity made of many particles. So you can rearrange those particles and you have a different shape and form and name. But Brahman is not a composite entity, it is a partless, homogeneous whole. Therefore, no potential to change. Brahman means consciousness cannot change. Therefore, the Jagat of the creation has to be superimposition. Samprati parinama shrutehe svarthe phala abhavat. This discussion becomes necessary because there appear to be the passages in Upanishads where it appears that Brahman has become creation. There are passages where it appears as though Brahman has become this creation. Therefore, all this discussion. So, if Brahman has become creation, what does that knowledge, what benefit does that knowledge give you? Please tell us. परिणाम श्रुते स्वार्थे फल अभावात. द श्रुति दैट सीम्स टू सजेस्ट दैट ब्रह्मन इज अंडरगोन अ चेंज, द नॉलेज ऑफ दैट चेंजफुल ब्रह्मन हैज नो बेनिफिट एट ऑल. एंड इफ नॉलेज डज नॉट हैव बेनिफिट देन दैट नॉलेज इज नॉट नॉलेज, इट हैज अ डिफरेंट पर्पस. If the knowledge does not bring about a benefit, that means that knowledge serves some other purpose. It serves the purpose of another knowledge which has benefit. So beneficial is called knowledge, phalavat. If some knowledge does not bring about any benefit, then we should conclude that that knowledge is a means of some other knowledge which will create benefit. So that's what Bhashyakara says, Nacha iti. Bhashyakara says, Nacha yatha brahmanah atmaikatva darshanam moksha sadhanam evam jagadakara parinamitva darshanam api svatantrameva kasmaichit phalaya abhiprayate pramana abhavat. Netha brahmana atmaikatva darshanam moksha sadhanam. It is well known, and Shruti also very clearly said that knowing Brahman as Atma, that knowledge is moksha sadhanam, is a means of liberation. That's all. Just this knowledge. You don't need anything else. Atma does not have to become Brahma, thank God. Atma happens to be Brahma. All that is necessary is to recognize that fact. And when you realize the fact that Atma is, I am Brahman, then all the sense of smallness disappears. The sense of smallness that arose in me on account of taking the body to be myself, that sense of smallness all drops when I come to know that I am not the body, I am Brahman. That sense of smallness was the cause of all the sorrow, therefore all the sorrow also disappears. So what is moksha? Moksha is freedom from all the sorrow. But Swami, how about ananda? When sorrow goes away, happiness automatically manifests. No separate efforts to be made. Just as when darkness goes away, the light manifests there simultaneously. Similarly also, the sorrow is veiling the happiness. When the veil of sorrow goes away, happiness automatically manifests. That is moksha. Atyandika dukkha nivrutti niritishe sukha avaptihi. The elimination of dukkha or sorrow once and for all, an attainment of unsurpassable happiness once and for all. So this is well known. Evam jagadakara parinamitva darshanam. Suppose you realize that Brahman has transformed itself in this jagat. Suppose that's the realization. Your realization is Brahman has transformed itself into this creation. What will that give you? Then creation remains separate from you. You continue to remain a limited entity and a sorrowful entity. So samsara remains intact. Therefore, svatantrameva. Even this knowledge also will give you result indirectly, all right, but directly. Knowing Brahman has transformed itself as jagat, in itself does not have any benefit at all. It can serve as a means of something else. So svatantram. Svatantram eva phalam. Kasmaichit phalayana abhiprayate. Nobody thinks that knowing Brahman as having changed into the universe, that knowledge has any immediate or direct benefit at all. Pramana abhavat, because you do not find any statement that says that knowing Brahman as a universe will liberate you. Nobody says that. Pramana abhavat. So says Jnani Nirnay, Brahma Jnanasya Phalam Tadeva Parinami Brahma Jnanasya Api Shastramayva Chatra Pramanamiti. So when Shastra says that by knowledge of, you get liberated by knowledge of Brahman, when Shastra says that liberation or moksha is a result of knowledge of Brahman, we say that is knowledge of changeful Brahman, suppose we say that. The Shastra, it can be interpreted to say that it is the knowledge of changeful Brahman that gives you moksha, suppose. He says, no, that is a pramanam. So pramana abhavat, that's the pramanam, says Iti Ashinga. Next line says, Kutasthat Kutasthat Brahmatmatma Vijnanat Evahi Phalam Darshayati Shastram Sa Esha Neti Neti Atma Ityupakramya Abhayavai Janaka Praptosi Ityevam Jatiyakam. No, Shruti very clearly said that there is the real benefit of knowing Brahman is changeless, that alone results into moksha and not anything else. Kutastha Brahmatmatva Vijnanadeva Phalam Darshani Shastram. Shastra, the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, very clearly says that moksha in this case is abhayam. Moksha, liberation, can be described in different ways. One way of describing moksha is freedom from fear. Abhayam pratishtham vindate. Taittiri Upanishad says that the wise person gains abundance in fearlessness. So Brihadaranyaka Upanishad there, see Yajnavalkya tells King Janaka, Abhayam vai Janaka praptosi. Hey Janaka, you have attained the fearlessness, the fearless. That is description of moksha. And Sayesha Neti Neti Atma, by knowledge of what? Atma, that is devoid of all the attributes Neti Neti. By knowledge of that Atma, that Janaka became fearless, Janaka became liberated. Iti. Therefore, when Shruti says that knowledge of Brahman gives moksha, it is not Brahman that is changeful, it is knowledge of changeless Brahman that is the means of moksha. This we already read, Ratnava first line, Kincha Nishphalasya Jagataha Phalavad Nishprapancha Brahmadi Sheshatvena Anuvadat. Therefore, all these Srishti Vakyas are either Arthavada or Anuvada. Brahmadi Sheshatvena. So, knowledge of the universe as Brahman is a means of, it leads to the knowledge of Brahman that is transcendental. Astityavopalabdhavya tattva bhavena chobayoho astityavopalabdhasya tattva bhava prasidati. First of all, Brahman is to be known as asti. The whole universe is nothing but Brahman, akhila brahmanda. The whole universe is Brahman. The manifest, Brahman is manifest as the universe. That's how it's to be first known. Tattva bhava, so Brahman is immanent, all pervasive. Tattva bhavena chobayoho, then it is known tattva bhava in its true nature, which is the transcendental nature. Astityo palabdhasya tattva bhava prasidati. For the one who is known Brahman as is, then that Brahman I am. So first Brahman is known as is, that leads to the knowledge of I am Brahman. So Brahman is becomes a helpful step towards realizing that I am Brahman. That's called Shesha. So Phalavat, and that knowledge I am Brahman is Phalavat. That brings me liberation. Nishprapancha Brahmadi Sheshatvena Anuvadat. So Jagat is a daily experience. It's just Anuvada. Wherever there is a description of Jagat or universe, is merely Anuvada. It is reiteration of what you already know. Na Satyata. So even though in the Upanishad you may find description of creation that is merely either Arthavada or Anuvada, it doesn't have Swarthe Tatpariyam, it doesn't have Satyata. So says Nyayanena Tarhi Parinami Shrutinam Anarthakyat. So two kinds of Shrutis are there. One is the Shrutis that talk about the Parinami Brahma, like the changeful Brahma. Others are the Shrutis that talk about Kutastha Brahma, changeless Brahman. You are saying that knowledge of changeless Brahman is beneficial and knowledge of changeful Brahman has no benefit. Tari Parinami Shrutinam Anarthakya. So that which does not serve the purpose is called anarthakam. So all the statements of Upanishad that talk about the Jagat or the creation, they all become meaningless. And that is not pramanam. Therefore, adhyana vidhi virodasyad. Every statement of Veda must be pramanam. So every statement of Veda must generate knowledge which is meaningful. But this knowledge of the creation does not generate any benefit at all. So it looks like it is meaningless. So what purpose does it serve? It says, phalavat sheshataya safalyat. Same thing. Even though it does not have phalam of its own, phalavat sheshataya. It is shesha or helpful or a means of knowledge which is beneficial. So knowledge of Brahman, Kutastha Brahma is beneficial, and knowledge of Parinami Brahma leads to the knowledge of Kutastha Brahma. Therefore, that is also meaningful. Tatra Subhashyakara says, Tatra etas siddham bhavate Brahma prakarane Sarvadharma Visheshrahita Brahma Darshanat Eva Palasiddhau Satya Yattatra Aphalam Shruyate Brahmanaha Jagadakara Parinamitvade Tad Brahma Darshanopayatve Naiva Viniyujyate phalavat sannidhau aphalam tadangam itivate natu svatantra phalaya kalpyate ite. Tatra eta siddham bhavati. Now when you have both kinds of statements talking about changeful Brahma for meditation. There are lots of meditations in Vedas and including in Upanishads also, where there is a meditation upon Brahman with attributes. Changeful Brahman. But that knowledge does not lead to moksha, then what is the use of that knowledge? This is a conclusion from this discussion. ब्रह्म प्रकरणे सर्वधर्म विशेष रहित ब्रह्म दर्शनादेव. इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ ब्रह्मन श्रुति इज वेरी क्लियर दैट ब्रह्मन इज डिवाइड ऑफ ऑल द एट्रीब्यूट्स एंड द नॉलेज ऑफ एट्रीब्यूटलेस ब्रह्मन और नॉलेज ऑफ चेंजलेस ब्रह्मन अलोन इज सीन और क्लियरली स्टेटेड टू बी फ्रूटफुल बेनिफिशियल फल सिद्ध सत्याम दैट अलोन गिव राइज टू द फल ऑफ द आउटकम इन द फॉर्म ऑफ मोक्ष. यत्र यत्तत्र अफलम श्रूयते देन देर आर मेनी स्टेटमेंट्स वेर देर इज नो फलम. यू सी इवन इन रामचरितमानस एंड ऑन दिस टेक्स्ट ऑल्सो भागवतम एल्सवेयर ऑल्सो द ग्रंथकार हिमसेल्फ और हरसेल्फ टेल्स यू व्हाट द फल इज दैट इफ यू repeat this, know this Sundarakanda, then what the phala is. Even the listening of the dialogue between Lord Rama and Sabri also, what phala it has. But there are many things about which phala is not heard. Knowing about Manthara and you know, Kaikeyi, all that knowledge, all that description, is not stated that any phala is there. So there are many portions of Ramcharitmanas knowing which does not generate any fruit or any benefit. Are they all useless? Should we discard them? He says, no, all of them are required to generate the knowledge of that which will give rise to phala. So knowing Kaikeyi and knowing Mantra, etc., etc., will bring about the Aranyakanda. And Kishkinda, Kanda, etc., the knowledge of which will be fruitful. So if this was not there, if Ayodhya Kanda was not there, then Aranya Kanda could not be. So even though we find that there is no benefit of knowing the charitra of Mantra and charitra of Kaikeyi, still that knowledge becomes indirectly meaningful by leading to the knowledge of Sundarkanda, etc., which are meaningful. So they also serve the purpose. They are also pramanam. Therefore, sarva-dharma visheshara-rahita brahma-darshana-deva phala-siddhau satyam. It is very clear, Shruti is very clear, that phala, namely moksha, is a result of knowledge of Brahman that is devoid of all the attributes. Yatra aphalam shruyate brahmana jagatkar jagadakara parinamitvat. So elsewhere, when you have the description of creation, where it may appear as though Brahman underwent a transformation to become the Jagat, but there is no result stated for that kind of a, you know, description. Aphalam shruyate. Shruti does not describe any phala or any benefit of knowing Brahman which is changeful. Does it mean that we should discard that part of the Shruti? Says no. तद् ब्रह्म दर्शन उपायेनैव विनियुज्यते. Therefore, that knowledge becomes a means of generating the knowledge of changeless Brahman. The knowledge of Parinami Brahma, changeful Brahman, becomes a means of knowledge of the Kutasa Brahma, changeless Brahman. For that, tatra, say, tatra eta siddham, tatra means what? Srushtya adishrutinam swarthe phalavaikalye sati. Now that is established that this the passage of the Upanishad, the Shastra, talking about creation, have no independent result. Therefore, they have an indirect result. in generating the knowledge of non-duality. The description of creation is the description of duality. What does that knowledge yield? Nothing. But that knowledge of non-duality is meant to lead to the knowledge of non-duality, which is beneficial. Just as karma yoga does not directly bring about moksha, but karma yoga brings about antahakana shuddhi or purification of mind, which becomes a means of vividisha, where vividisha, vairagya and mumukshutvam arise, which then leads to moksha. Once pratham bhumika aroha is there, you are on an escalator. By abhyasa of each bhumika, the next bhumika automatically evolves or develops or manifests. Tatra mimamsakavatam udaharanamah. This is what mimamsaka say. Phalavas sannidhau afalam tadangam itivata. Phalavat sannidhau, in the proximity of something which is beneficial, which has a fruit, which has a result. Afalam, if there is something which is in the vicinity, then we should understand that as the anga or a part of the main ceremony. Says here, explain the statement. Yathahi Svargadi phalavataha darshapurna masadehe sannidhane shrutam. Just as the darshapurna masa yaga. Darsha means done in amavasya. Purna masa is paunami. So that yaga is called darshapurna masa, and that yaga is stated to have lead to seven swarga. So darshapurna masa yaga definitely has a result in the form of swarga. Then there are other small yaga, prayaja, etc. Other yagas also described, which do not have any result. Shruti doesn't say what result you get by performing this prayaja. So prayaja adi svataha vifalam tat angam iti angi kriyate. So mimamsaka have concluded that this prayaja itself, which do not generate independent result, are all anga, or they are all parts of, or they are all the accessories of the main yaga, which is darshapurnamasa. For example, there will be a lot of description of what benefit you get when you do the Satyanarayana puja. But for Satyanarayana puja, you must do Varuna puja and Ganesha puja and so many other little, for which there is no result stated. Does it mean that Varuna puja, Ganesha puja perform during the Satyanarayana puja, they have no meaning? Should we discard them? He says, no, they are anga, they are limbs of the main puja, they complete the puja. तथा सृष्ट्यादि दर्शनापि ब्रह्मज्ञान शेषतया तत्फलेनैव फलत्वात्. So therefore, even knowing the srushti etc. is meaningful, because knowing of the duality leads to the knowledge of non-duality. द्वे विद्ये वेदितव्ये इति हस्मयत् ब्रह्मविदो वदन्ति पराचैव अपराच. Upanishad says that these two forms of knowledge must be gained, paravidya and aparavidya. Aparavidya does not have any direct result, only paravidya. Yayatat aksharam adhigamyate athapara. So by paravidya you gain the knowledge of the immutable Brahman, not by aparavidya, but still aparavidya is to be known because it leads to the paravidya. By generating vairagya, so aparavidya is all karma kanda, and that also is important. But vidhi nisheda, living life like that, you become an Arya. Antakaran Shuddhi takes place, Mumuksha takes place. Says Nanu, Prayajadehe Shuyamane Phalaineva Phalavatva Sambhave. Hey, but when Prayaja is part of the Darshapurna Masa, when Prayaja is part of Darshapurna Masa, then when Darshapurna Masa leads to Swarga, so Prayaja also leads to Swarga, isn't it? So Prayaja Dehe Shruyamana Phalaineva Phalavatva. Therefore, you don't have to imagine the Prayaja also is independently contributing. So why do you call Prayaja Anga as a limb of the Darshapurna Masa? Iti Ashankya Pradhana Phalaineva Phalavatva Siddhau. Says, no, Prayaja is not, doesn't have independent result. He contributes to the Darshapurnamasa, and Darshapurnamasa is meaningful. That indirectly, Prayaja by way of Darshapurnamasa becomes meaningful. Phalantara kalpane gauravat, otherwise Prayaja is this phala, there is that phala, this phala, so many phalas will be there. Gauravam, too many phalas. So one phala, namely Swarga, all of this contribute to that. They are part of that. So Vashyakara said, Natu Svatantram Phalaya Kalpyate. Therefore, this knowledge of this Srishti does not independently yield any result. It yields results by way of contributing to the knowledge of non-dual Brahma. Then says Ratnaprabha, tam yatha yatha upasate tadeva bhavati iti shrutehe. Tam yatha yatha upasate, tam paramatmanam yatha yatha upasate, in whichever way you meditate upon Brahma, tadeva bhavati, that's what you become. Whichever way you meditate upon Brahman, that's what you become. So if you meditate upon changing Brahman, you become changing. That's what it means. Iti shrute brahmana parinamitva vijnanat. Brahman is the object of upasana, object of meditation. That it can be meditated upon, and whatever can be meditated upon has to be changing. Understand that the changeless self cannot become the object of meditation because it is the very self of the meditator. Therefore, for meditating upon changeless Brahman, even the meditator also has to be dropped. Samhar karna padega. Yena tyajasi tat tyaja. So that by which you are giving up, give up the giver up also. Meaning that Nirvesesham Brahma or Nirgunam Brahman cannot become the object of meditation. What can be meditated upon is Saguna Brahma, meaning Brahman with attributes superimposed upon that. So that is changing Brahman alone can become the object of meditation, and by meditating upon changing Brahman, do you also become changing? Does the Atma start changing? So, tat praptahi vidushaya phalam. Why not the meditator has the phalam, the result in the form of attainment of changing Brahma? Nahi, so Bhashyakara says, Nahi parinama vatva vijnanat. Parinama vatvam atmana phalam syat iti vaktum yuktam kutastha nityatvat mokshasya नहीं परिणामवत्व विज्ञानात् परिणामवत्व मीन्स व्हाट दैट विच इज पजेस्ड दैट विच पजेसेस चेंज सो बाय द नॉलेज ऑफ चेंजफुल ब्रह्मन दैट आत्मा शुड ऑल्सो स्टार्ट चेंजिंग दैट कैन नॉट बी आत्मा इज चेंजलेस एंड देयरफॉर परिणामवत्व आत्मना फलम सादि वक्तुम न युक्तम यू कैन नॉट से दैट द नोअर ऑल्सो बिकम्स चेंजिंग एंटिटी कूटस्थ नित्यत्वात् मोक्षस्य बिकॉज मोक्ष इज चेंजलेस एंड इटर्नल एंड मोक्ष मीन्स इट इज रिजल्ट ऑफ नॉलेज ऑफ आत्मा दैट इज इटर्नल एंड चेंजलेस सो आई एम मेडिटेटिंग अपॉन ब्रह्मन दैट इज चेंजिंग आत्मा कैन नॉट बिकम चेंजिंग देयरफॉर नॉलेज ऑफ changing brahman has to be accepted as an anga as a part of the overall purpose of the knowledge of the non dual changeless brahman iti no that is different okay so that earlier iti phalai kalpe iti siddham bhavati dane saidi siddham bhavati okay शेष न्याय निर्णय तस्य तावदेव इत्यादिना प्रतिपन्नम कैवल्यम विहाय व्हाय शुड यू सेटल फॉर एन इन्फीरियर रिजल्ट तस्य तावदेव चिरम यावन्न विमोक्षे अथ संपत्स्ये दैट स्टेटमेंट क्लियरली सेज दैट ही बिकम्स वन विद ब्रह्म वन विद सत अथ सत संपत्स्ये आई विल बिकम सत और ब्रह्म Meaning that identity with Brahman is the result and Brahman is kutastham. So giving up that result, samanya shastra siddha phalakarshane vakya bhedasya aditi bhavaha. If you attach the phala, limited phala to knowledge, that would be vakya bheda. It is giving two things. It gives moksha as well as some brahmaloka etc which is not right says ratnaprabha brahmavit aapnoti paramiti kutastha nitya moksha phala sambhave another example brahmavit aapnoti param The knower of Brahma attains the limitless. Param has to be changeless, understand? Param means limitless. Limitless must necessarily be changeless. Because a changeful entity cannot be limitless. A changeful entity is under the influence of time. It is perishable. What is perishable cannot be limitless. Therefore, Param means kutastham. So, Brahma with apnodi param, The knower of Brahma attains the supreme, the limitless. Iti kutastha nitya moksha phala sambhave. So param is kutastham and nityam. So you attain what is kutastham, changeless, nityam, the eternal. That's what the knower of Brahma attains. When that is possible, dukkha anitya parinamitva फलकल्पना अयोगात व्हाट्स द यूज ऑफ अटेनिंग द चेंजफुल ब्रह्म बिकॉज चेंजफुल चेंज इज देयर वेदर इज चेंज देयर इज दुख वेदर इज चेंज देयर इज पेरिशेबल अनित्य वेदर इज चेंज देयर इज द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन सो इफ यू बिकम चेंजफुल ब्रह्मन देन यू आर अंडरगोइंग ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन देन यू आर अंडरगोइंग चेंज Then you are having sorrow because change generates sorrow. So why should you imagine that kind of a result when becoming kutastha nitya, changeless, eternal, that phala which is clearly stated in Shruti, when that can be the mukhya phala, why should you imagine that this is a phala of Brahmajnanam? What does Brahmajnana give you? He says Brahmajnana gives you the identity with the changeful Brahma. Why not? Such changeful means anityam. It is perishable. It is non-eternal. Therefore, dukkhatmaka limited. Therefore, dukkhatmakam. So, why do you want that kind of result? When the result of identity with the changeless, limitless is possible. Iti bhavaha. Okay, we'll continue.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavad Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.